Hey guys, it's Marje. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So, before we get started, I want you guys to please go and like and subscribe to my YouTube page, okay? A girl is trying to do things and I can't do it without you guys' help. Please and thank you. So, it's been a minute since I've done something like this. So, today I want to give you guys some words of encouragement and inspiration to keep going through the struggles of trying to achieve your goals and dreams. So, I'm going to just drop a few tips that I have learned over the time with pursuing my dreams and goals, and hopefully it will be able to help you guys out there. So, first I want to say, sometimes you have to take a look at your circumstances and you are asking all these questions and you're wondering why, and you're getting upset and you're getting frustrated and you're not where you want to be. My first thing is to slow down, pause, just pump your brakes, like really evaluate what you have been doing and where you are. Look at your accomplishments, look at your achievements, and look at the things that haven't gone so well. Evaluate those things, make observations, and see where it is that you can make a difference in the outcome of what's going on. So slow down. Your career, your job, all that stuff isn't going anywhere. It really isn't. But slow down and really just take some time to yourself to reflect. My next thing is to take responsibility. Oftentimes I found myself blaming the world for why things were the way they were. Oh, it's because I'm plus size. Oh, it's because my skin isn't like this. Oh, it's because my hair is straight. Or it's because my hair isn't straight. It's, you know, it's natural. Oh, they didn't like me. Oh, I didn't smell like this. I don't look like this girl. Stop with all the excuses. Stop blaming the world and really take responsibility for your actions. Like for me, I started to realize that I wanted all these things to start happening. But when I asked myself, have I done my part? Have I done all the things that I needed to do for my career to be where I want to be? And the answer was no. I had not invested in myself. I had not taken the classes that I needed to take. So within doing that, I, you know, redirected my train of thought. That's why I said sometimes you need to slow down. You need to evaluate what you are doing and take responsibility for your actions so that you can be the person that you want to be. Okay, my next thing would be, I already kind of said this, would be to evaluate yourself. Not in a negative way, but to evaluate yourself in a positive way so that you can make sure that you are on the right path of where you want to go. So evaluate yourself. Look at the things that aren't positive and try to turn them around. Cool. Read literature. For me, there's so much time that I spend traveling to work or to gigs. I utilize that time reading. Read, feed your mind, feed your brain with something positive. Get off Instagram, get off Facebook, get off social media. Sometimes you need to disconnect from those things as they can sometimes bring you down. So, read some literature. Read something that can inspire you. Read something that can push you or propel you forward. Learn something new. So yeah, there's that. Work on you and do the work. You cannot be lazy and want to be a success. You cannot be lazy and want to be great and want to achieve all these things that you guys have, you know, put on your to-do list or your goal or your vision boards. You have to do the work. If that means studying, if that means staying up late, if that means putting in the time, going to the gym, eating healthy, getting your skin together, do what you have to do, but do not be lazy. You cannot be lazy. It's no excuse. Stop making excuses and stop being lazy. Please. Do it for yourself. The next thing would be to stay focused on your goals and dreams. Don't get sidetracked with outside life and stuff, though those things are natural and it will happen, but stay focused on your dreams. Make sure that, you know, your partner knows where you're going in your life and you're focused and they're okay with what you're doing. Because some people get caught up in relationships. Don't do that. Your relationship should, you know, be a nice accessory to where you're already going. Be independent. Have your own wants and needs without that person. My next thing would be compare despair. Do not compare yourself to anyone else. The only person person that you should be comparing yourself to is the person you were yesterday. Continue to push forward and become a better you. Do not look to your left. Do not look to your right. Stay focused and look forward. Please. Compare, despair. My next thing would be lead with love. Continue to lead with love, to promote positivity, to be positive. Train your thought to be more positive versus negative. Do not talk down about yourself. Do not talk bad about yourself. Build up confidence, build up, you know, your positivity, like, I don't know, thoughts. You have to build that up. It really helps and it goes a long way. Walk in confidence. Love yourself. Love yourself. Love yourself. So yeah, as I continue on this journey, I am continuing to work on these things that I'm telling you guys about, and hopefully they can help you. But stay strong and don't give up. Never quit, because you never know what tomorrow may bring. Stay strong. Bye.